Motion carries 8-0. Okay, I'll make a motion to approve the following bank depositories, items A through F. Seconded by Dr. Thompson. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0. Make a motion to approve the following cooperative purchase participation for the 2019-2020 fiscal year, items A through I. Seconded by Mr. Rice. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0. I make a motion to review the end of year payment of all bills received and payable through June 30th, 2019 as necessary. Bill lists will be forwarded to all board members prior to the release of the check. Of the checks, any checks in question will be resolved before they are released for payment. Seconded by Mr. Rice. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0. And the next Finance Committee meeting is scheduled for Tuesday, July 9th. We made it to the end. Okay, and next is the Intermediate Unit Report. The Bucks County Intermediate Unit met on May 22nd. So we received an update on the STEAM program that was going to homeless shelters. Children were engaged in many great activities, including bunny marshmallow catapults and programming the Ozobots. They were so excited and they got the opportunity to take a project home with them. This project is funded from grants. We also extended Dr. Hoffman's contract. He was halfway through his contract and the board voted to give him a new four-year contract with the same terms. Also, the Bucks County Intermediate Unit had a very special and emotional retirement celebration for the retirees. They shared some beautiful stories about some of their coworkers that were retiring and highlighted how much of a positive impact they had on students and everyone around them. There was also a playground dedication, and Dr. Hoffman made the point about how they always come back, so he's expecting that all of these people will come back in some capacity or other, and most of them are proving him true, are proving that to be true. There was also a playground dedication for Lower Southampton Early Learning Center. The playground was funded by a $225,000 grant from the Office of Head Start through the Health and Safety Supplemental Funding after they had an opportunity to visit and see the vision. The playground was a huge hit for kids. We got to see the kids go out and play on the playground, and it was a really neat experience, and they did a great job, and it was kind of an all-ability playground theme, which was really neat to see. They talked about, with the early childhood program, how they're focusing on making it as inclusive as possible. So they've combined Head Start and pre-K counts and also the early intervention program so that they have kids that are from all of these different groups in the same preschools together. And there's an effort to make this even more inclusive. One of the things they're looking to do is they're looking to become certified so that they can offer additional positions to kids on a tuition basis. So if anyone wants to send their kids to an early childhood program, they could pay the cost and have their child join that program. And so it would add some more opportunities to have an even more inclusive environment. And they're doing, you know, this is funded through grants, and they're expanding these, they're offering these programs all over the county. They're opening more over the summer for next year in different areas of the county. A preliminary view of the intermediate unit's comprehensive annual budget for the 2019-2020 fiscal year was shared at the meeting. The budget has been prepared with the assistance of each program's director and special program supervisors. The budget includes 26 budgets within the general, special revenue, and capital projects fund that equal over $176 million. The complete comprehensive annual budget document is going to be presented at the June meeting tomorrow. Though the total budget is up from $163 million last year, That increase is due to the substantial expansion of services, which are funded through grants and other means, with no direct increase in cost to districts. For example, when we talked about these new programs, like the early childhood programs that are expanding, those programs that are being opened throughout the county obviously cost more money, but those projects are being funded through grants. The small portion of the budget that has a direct impact on the school districts and that's voted on by the school districts is the programs and services budget, which is based on a per student cost, and that was already approved by us and by the other districts earlier this year. That cost per student did not go up, so the only increase we saw was the number of, you know, was based on the fact that more students were receiving services, and so that number is direct, you know, but the per student cost stayed the same. And Dr. Bolton already highlighted the Bucks County IU graduation, and that was a really, really neat experience to see those kids and what they accomplished and hear the speeches from some of those kids and their life situations and what got them to where they are. And they were dynamic speakers and very entertaining and had a great sense of humor. So it was really a neat experience to see them. So the next IU meeting is tomorrow night. So you're all welcome to come. And next up on the agenda is the personnel report, Dr. Yarnell.
Thank you. The personnel committee has not met since the last board meeting, including in June. We do have some motions tonight. First of all is a motion to approve a memorandum of understanding, MOU, between the Pennridge School District and the Pennridge Educational Support Professionals Association. This has to do with summer hours and working times. So I move that we approve that memorandum.
Seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Second item is to approve the Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Education. For elementary education first, that would be Dr. Anthony Grabarczyk. He is a previous member of the Pennridge community. He was a principal grass, and we are asking that this motion be approved for his start August 5th, 2019, at a salary of $155,000, pending the solicitor review of the contract.
I'll second that.
I knew there was going to be a jump to try to second that one. Questions or comments from board members? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Second is to approve the Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Education. That would be Dr. Kathy Scheib, and she would be taking this responsibility effective July 1, 2019, at a salary of $155,000.
Second.
I'll give Mrs. Cullen this one. Seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
We also have a motion tonight to approve Dr. Stephen Cashman as the high school principal effective July 1, 2019 at a salary of $148,314.
I'll second.
Seconded by Mr. Rice. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Item F, the approval of the security guard. Motion to approve Sergeant Joseph Gallo as security guard for the 2019-2020 school year at a salary of $30,923.
Seconded by Mrs. Walters. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
AFG is a motion to approve the following. Sergeant Joseph Gallo as Director of Security, School Police Officer, pending successful completion of weapon certification, physical exam, psychological exam, and first aid CPR training at a salary of $15,000. Start date to be determined by the satisfactory completion of the requirements previously stated. And also, Mr. Dan Branch as a school police officer, pending successful completion of weapon certification, physical exam, psychological exam, and first aid CPR training at a salary of $15,000. Start date is to be determined by satisfactory completion of the requirements previously stated.
I apologize. There is an error in the agenda. Item B should read at a salary of $10,000. It is the Director of Security that adds the extra $5,000. Mr. Branch is. So, Mr. Miller, we're going to rely on you in terms of how we get ourselves out of a motion and a second.
I assume that Dr. Yarnell will accept that as a friendly amendment.
I do so accept it.
Mr. Branch.
So we have a motion. Do we have a second?
Yes.
Seconded by Mr. Krause. Questions or comments for board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Nay.
Okay, motion passes 7-1. Okay.
Item H is approval of the Director of Administration for additional summer work days. Motion to approve Dr. Troy Price, Director of Administration, to work for an additional 10 days beyond his originally scheduled end date of June 30th, 2019, and to be completed on or before August 7th, 2019, at his current per diem rate.
Seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Item I is approval of K-12 Supervisor of Reading English Language Arts. The motion is to approve Sarah Raver as K-12 Supervisor of Reading English Language Arts, effective July 1, 2019, at a salary of $115,904.
Seconded by Mr. Rice. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Dr. Yuna, may I interrupt? Give you a
I think you already have.
May I interrupt for a little longer? I have some people that I want you to meet. Now that we've gone through those motions, many of those people are here tonight. I want to give you an opportunity to see their faces and also congratulate them and hear from a couple of them. So first, I'd like to recognize Dr. Anthony Rabarczyk, who's our new Assistant Superintendent for Elementary Education. And besides telling us that you have wonderfully behaved children, because I have not heard a peep the entire time they've been here, and it's already 8:14. So would you just briefly tell us a little bit about yourself and how you're coming home?
Sure. Thank you so much. And it is an absolute honor and privilege to be coming back to the Penridge community. Just coming back to serve. I have been excited about this opportunity since we started the process and willing to just have the opportunity to work with Kathy again. Kathy and I, our paths have crossed in the past, and again, it's just an absolute honor to be here, and I thank all of you, my family, for coming up, my mother-in-law, father-in-law, and all the children that are there, and my wife, Jeannie, so thank you so much.
Awesome. Thank you, Tony. Welcome. Next, I'd like to congratulate Dr. Kathy Schott on her new position as Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Education. Kathy, congratulations.
Love every day that I've spent at Penridge, and I'm certainly looking forward to working with Dr. Rabarczyk and Dr. Cashman and the whole administrative team. So thank you so much for your support.
Next is Dr. Stephen Cashman, who effective July 1st will be the next principal of Penridge High School. So Steve, welcome.
Good
Thank you. I just want to let you know how excited I am about the opportunity. As we were going through the process, I learned a lot about the Penn Ridge School District, but as I went through the interviews and had a chance to meet a lot of the people within Penn Ridge, I've learned a lot more than just about test scores and about student achievement. I've learned a lot about the people who are here, and I'm really excited to not just to work with all of you, but also to work with the students that we saw tonight and some of the wonderful teachers we had a chance to see too. So thank you. I appreciate the opportunity.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
$5,
so thank you for coming tonight. I'd like to also introduce you to Sergeant Joe Gallo. So Joe, if you'd stand up and say hi to everybody. Welcome.
Hi, everyone.
Sergeant Gallo has recently retired from the New York City Police Department, where he has worked for the past 22 years, both as a patrolman and also as a sergeant. For 9 of those years, he worked directly in schools. As a sergeant of a police force in multiple schools, primarily in the Staten Island area. He has tremendous experience with school policing as well as emergency planning. He's going to be a wonderful asset. So welcome to Penn Ridge.
Thank you.
We're fortunate to have you. I'd also like to congratulate and welcome to his new role, Mr. Dan Branch. Dan. Worked as a security guard in Penn Ridge in some form, both part-time and full-time, since 2011. Prior to that, he was an officer in the Penn Ridge Regional Police Department for 10 years. He is well-known at the high school and respected by both students and staff, and I know that he will continue to have a positive impact on the student and staff safety and wellness. So Dan, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to also introduce... Okay. I'd also like to introduce you to Sarah Raver, who is, as of July 1st, going to be our K-12 Supervisor of Reading, English, and Language Arts. So, Sarah, welcome to the program. I'd also like to just mention, in terms of from the school police officer standpoint, in terms of the trainings that are mentioned there, what we have decided to do is to match the trainings that are required of Penn Ridge Regional Police Officers. And so we've had a conversation both with the state as well as Penn Ridge Regional in terms of what do they do as they bring on new police officers. And so in those areas that are mentioned there, we are going to match their training. The state has said that that would be more than appropriate, as well as the additional trainings they'll need to do. But those are the ones that match Penn Ridge Regional. I'd also like to thank Dr. Price for agreeing to work additional days as we transition to Dr. Rubarczyk. That is primarily to complete our federal grants, which is primarily a July activity. And so he'll be able to finish that, as well as then spend transition time with Dr. Rubarczyk. So Dr. Price, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Rubarczyk.
Thank you. Last motion is to approve the Director of Finance. The motion is to approve Amy Light as Director of Finance, effective July 1, 2019, at a salary of $109,898.
Seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
The next meeting of the Personnel Committee is slated for Monday, September 9th, 2019.
Next is the Policy Committee. Ms. Galeri?
Okay, Policy Committee is not meeting in June. We have approved the policy for our first reading. I have a motion to approve the first reading of Policy Number 231, Student Rights.
Questions or comments from board members? I would just like to comment that this essentially, for student trips, the idea is that students can then travel out of the country, because we had a trip that was supposed to be passed and we weren't able to pass it because it violated policy, because the policy did not allow for students to be able to participate in trips that were out of the country. And so this gives us the ability to pass those other trips. Any other questions or comments from board members? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
Okay, I need a motion, to approve the following policies, number 124.2, dual enrollment, dual concurrent enrollment, policy 214, class rank, policy 707, use of school facilities.
Seconded by Mrs. Cullen. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries 8-0.
And the next policy committee meeting is scheduled for Tuesday, September 3rd.
Thank you, Ms. Bozeri. And next is the technology committee. Mr. Rice?
The technology committee did not meet in the month of June. Sad emotion. But the next committee meeting will be Monday, September 9th. Smiley emoji.
Thank you, Mr. Rice. Next is the Upper Bucks County Technical School. Okay, so the Upper Bucks County Technical School met on Thursday, May 16th. And the next meeting is scheduled for this Thursday, June 20th. There is one thing important that I wanted to highlight, but I want to get it right so that I find it first. I would have had Jeff Sweeta highlight it for us, but he already skipped out on us. Where? Did he switch seats?
No, he's just at work.
Oh, okay. Anyway. The Upper Bucks County Technical School placed first as a team in the veterinary science qualifying for nationals in Indianapolis in October. They also beat the repeat champs Chester County's TCHS pennant. In addition, they had great individual placements. Casey Rottenberger placed first as an individual and earning $100 towards her college education at Del Valle next year. Isabella Urban placed third as an individual, and Stephanie Hernandez and Nina Slaper both placed competitively in the top 10 as individuals. We are very proud and excited for our students and instructor to qualify for nationals in October. It was a great year for the Upper Bucks County Technical School, the FFA, and the Animal Tech program. Anything else you want to highlight?
I missed those. I was talking to your new principal.
Okay. And so our next meeting is this Thursday. Next is the Act 48 Committee. Mrs. Walters?
Thank you. The Act 48 Committee will not meet for the remainder of the 2018-2019 school year. And our next committee meeting will occur on Thursday, November 7th, 2019.
Thank you, Mrs. Walters. Next is the Penn Ridge Area Coordinating Committee. Dr. Thompson?
Yes, the Penn Ridge Area Coordinating Committee met on May 23rd. I was not able to attend because I was attending the Senior Awards night, which was fantastic, but I did receive a report from David Nyman, who facilitated the meeting. So from a lot going on in the district, from Silverdale, the Borough Green Street project is underway, and they also wanted to let you know that the concert series is on their website, but the next concert for the summer is a Sting review, which sounds cool. And it's at the Roscoe and Verna Moyer Pavilion at the Al Reese Park, and that will be on, I can't read my writing, July 14th, 4 p.m., and the rain date will be July 21st. From the West Rock Hill Township, the township plans to fight the gas line compressor station, and they plan to do that by hiring an environmental attorney to file objections. They also reported that they continued work with the state Senator Santacero and Congressman Fitzpatrick to obtain funding to provide public water to residents affected by the PFAS contamination. Bedminster Township approved a short-term Airbnb ordinance, and they wanted to let you know that the Weiss Market project continues to be progressing towards a fall opening. In Dublin, the township announced that the old bank building is demoed and the tech center renovation is underway. East Rock Hill Township, actually Mrs. Baines Clemens already reported the highlights for the quarry, and that's earlier in the school board meeting. The Penridge Community Center wanted to report that they've officially reopened their center with all of their damage repaired, and they have an official grand reopening scheduled for Sunday, June 23rd, so you want to check that out on their website. The Percy Borough wanted to let you know that Penridge Community Day is July 7th. The event is organized by the Penridge Chamber of Commerce and the Percy Rotary. The Under the Stars Car Show is August 17th, and the Summer Concert Series, which is also you can find on their website, will be on Wednesdays throughout the summer. And the Farmers Market is now open Saturdays until October 26th, and there's Mondays in Menlo, which you can check out that on their website as well. And the new industrial development along Ridge Road, a lot of people have been interested in that. It's under construction. PennDOT is requiring a section of Ridge Road to be widened. This will most likely occur in August or September, and there will also be lane restrictions for about 2 weeks in July. So the Borough Council also saw plans from the developer for the former Delbar property. The developer is proposing converting the existing buildings into 90 apartments. The next step would be for the developer to submit for land development plans. In Sellersville Borough, the PennDOT Bridge Replacement Project currently underway by the Fire Hall is on track to be completed by the end of June, but I'll let you know, it'll probably be done by the end of the week. So the next PennDOT bridge project is to rehabilitate that bridge, the railroad bridge, carrying across North Main Street over the SEPTA tracks at St. Michael's Church. That project is expected to start mid-June, but they haven't started it yet. So it might be closer to July, and it should be completed by October 2020. So that is it going on, but that's a lot. And the next meeting actually is not this month. We won't be meeting again until September 27th at the Penridge Community Center.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson. One of the things I should have mentioned when I was talking about the quarry report, there is the contaminated water situation that's also partially in West Rock Hill, partially in East Rock Hill, in the old Bethlehem Pike area there, and there are houses that are affected by that. Those people are actually drinking bottled water and brushing their teeth with bottled water. That's how bad the contamination is on that road. And so there were concerns that were raised regarding the quarry that the potential of this water then contaminating the other areas with the quarry. One of the things that DEP said, that they believe that that it's not the same aquifers and that would not happen, but they're going to look into that more carefully. And they also agreed that if the quarry was to move forward, they would have language in there that would protect people in case that was to happen. But that is something that they're looking into, and it was something that was a significant concern that was raised, because if that contaminated water, if there is any chance that contaminated water could contaminate other people's water, they did say that they will not approve it if that is the case. So they are investigating that. So that's another piece of that. We didn't get to talk about the fixing of the water situation that's already there because it wasn't the topic of the day. If we could have kept them a little longer, maybe we could have gotten into that one. And also, West Rock Hill Township did file an appeal with regard to the compressor station. So we'll see what happens with the appeal that West Rock Hill filed. And next is the Penridge Community